Introduction. In introduction, I must to point attention to three important points. First of all, how we know in the asteroid belt between Jupiter and Mars, we can see many minor planets which called asteroid. These minor planets moving in vicinity of number of resonances with large planets. In the most of the resonances, we have gaps and small number of asteroids. On the other hand, as a point, we have about 15% of asteroids with satellites. Interesting to discuss what will be when the asteroids will cross the resonance. Third point is that the number of asteroids moving on the very close orbits. In the present time, we know more than 90 such pairs, which orbits with a very small distance between orbits. Give the simpler model of the interaction of asteroid with satellite with resonance. First of all, we consider the difference between the velocity of asteroid, primary asteroid, and its satellite. This velocity due to orbital motion of asteroid around the primary occur the difference in semi-major axis and eccentricity.
Oh. Sorry, it looks like the slides are not moving on the main screen, so I just need to make sure that we...
Sorry.
No. It's just people in Zoom, they can see only this main slide. So we need to... So they just see this, you see? So let's just at least let's share this one. And here...
Okay.
So, is this a better solution? I suppose. Mm-hmm. Is it okay for you?
Okay. In this equations, we write this. Relation between the orbital elements and the relative velocity between the primary and the satellite. This difference in orbital elements will be important if we consider the model of interaction with resonance. We use the simple model of pendulum, which is supposed by Murray and Dermot. They consider the perturbation function and the equation for resonance argument in this form, second order equation for resonance argument, where the constant expressed by this expression. This dependence, this equation for Reza argument is easy to rewrite for the mean motion. Use the equation of Lagrange equation of orbital elements. The equation for mean motions has a such a view, and it is easy to rewrite it for the semi-major axis. After the differentiation of this equation, we can obtain roughly expression for the relative acceleration between the primary and satellite, which is due to the resonance interaction. This difference in acceleration may be expressed through the values of distance in orbital elements, eccentricity on the semi-major axis or mean motion. After that, we obtain, finally, we obtain the expression in for the relative acceleration in the terms of a component of velocities, radial and tangential velocities. After that, we can approximate velocity, tangential and radial velocity by orbital velocity of satellite around the primary asteroid. And finally, we obtained the final estimation for relative acceleration in this form. Here I use the approximate value of a constant C R and the term multiplication A on phi D has was given in the book of Newbery and Dermot for most simple case of resonance of first order. It is interesting to maximal value of F is a unit, and it is interesting to compare this relative acceleration with acceleration of primary asteroid and the acceleration of sun, which is a tidal acceleration difference, acceleration of perturbation of sun on the primary and the satellite. After assuming of mean motion and mass of asteroid, mass is related the asteroid with a diameter 2 kilometers, and the period of rotation secondary around the primary asteroid is 30 hours, we obtained the following estimation. On this graph, blue line is a acceleration due to gravity attraction of primary asteroid. Red line is a solar tidal force, and the black line is a maximal value of the relative acceleration due to resonance transfer. It is possible to see the value of these three acceleration are comparable in the distance about 70 kilometers from the primary. It means that the resonance perturbation in the time of crossing resonance by asteroid satellite it has a strong value and can to assist to destroy the binary system or the system of asteroid with a satellite. At least it can significantly reduce the heliosphere radius for this system. To write the differential equation for relative acceleration, for relative difference in semi-motion axis, we note that mean motion n is proportional to delta A acceleration, and finally we can obtain the differential equation with variable coefficients. View of the function phi is following. In the function phi, we can see a few terms with different frequencies. This is frequencies mean motion of a secondary around the primary asteroid orbital frequency, and the frequency related with the motion of a system around the sun, heliocentric anomaly, and the frequency related with the resonance oscillation. So these may be complex picture in the result related with a few possible parametric resonance. Then we illustrate this model, simple model with the numeric integration of real asteroid pyre. Pyre Fidioia and the next asteroid 2004 VF21. This pyre has a proper semi-major axis, mean semi-major axis is about this one, and observed center of chaotic zone is this one. Nominal position of resonance is in this line, and this resonance is a three-body resonance with Mars, Jupiter, and asteroid. I now must note that most of the resonance important for asteroid dynamics of asteroid pyre dynamics is the three body resonances, not simple two body resonances. And important, the small but difference between these three value of semi-major axis. First of all, important to study why is not considered the nominal resonance position and the center of the observed chaotic zone It is a very important problem. Encountered in studying exoplanets, for example, but at this moment I don't know the solution of it. I use three catalogs of resonance in the solar system, same method to calculate of this resonance, and all of these methods are different from observed value of relative zones center obtained by numerical integration result. And this picture view can see the result of our numerical integration of this called asteroid pairs on the time interval h 100 of 1000 years. You can see the very close orbits of these two asteroids in the present epoch, and these asteroids display the jumps across the resonance from one side of the resonance to another side, and this behavior repeated continuously on all interval of integration. It is useful to note that largest of asteroid in this pair, Ophidioia, has a real satellite on the orbit is about 30 kilometers in vicinity of them, with the semi-major axis about 30 kilometers. But what is the reason of jumps? In this problem, we must to write the equation for resonance argument again. And after that, we can approximate the value of node longitude and the perihelion longitude of asteroid and the planet in time, and the substitute this approximation is in the expression for semi-major axis of multiplet, resonance multiplet. Evidently, the resonance multiplet will consist of a number of terms, and the number of these terms increase with the order of resonance. In this case, in this page, I give a case of simple two-body resonance, but it is not difficult to write these similar equations, similar conditions for the case of a three-body resonance. And if we apply the numerical integration with a smaller step, we obtain in the direct vicinity of the resonance similar view. At the approach to the resonance, we have a small variation of semi-major axis, which is a brown line. And at the epoch about 20,000 years, we see the increasing of amplitude of the oscillation of semi-major axis, and in the same time, decreasing of period of the oscillation. it is interesting to study, is this oscillation related with the libration around the resonance, or is not related with this? But at this moment, I don't know with sure what it, what version is true. On the top line, we see the change of perihelion longitude of Jupiter. As it is easy to see, when the asteroid Fidioria cross the resonance, the longitude of perihelion of Jupiter will change with large speed relative to the period when the asteroid is away from the resonance. It is an illustration of a previous slide when I give the dependence of the position of resonance multiplet on the rate of change of perihelion and node angles. But in this backward integration, I try to use a real model of the asteroid with a satellite on the orbit in the distance of 70 kilometers from the Fidioria. In the result, I obtain following pictures, following projection of this orbit of this satellite. Before the resonance, we can see the motion with a very small eccentricity. And after the resonance transfer, eccentricity of the orbit of satellite increases very strongly. It means that system of asteroid with satellite can really destroy during the resonance transfer. But there are no, I cannot obtain in this simple integration escape of the secondary, but more probably case is the collision of the this secondary asteroid with the primary, because the distance in the motion on orbit after the resonance transfer is smaller than 1 kilometer. It means that collision with the central mass in this system is very probable. Last moment is following. This numerical integration result is required to very careful not to overestimate this result. In this picture, you see the numerical integration with two program of this asteroid Fidioria with the same initial condition. This asteroid has a different, strongly different motion after the 400,000 years. And the orbit become unstable. It means that not only, we cannot believe only to numeric backward integration result, but theoretic studying in this problem are strongly required and have a value. A few conclusions. Difference acceleration of primary unsettled during resonance atmosphere comparable with solar perturbation. In combination with other perturbation, it can destroy asteroid binary system. And the numeric method has a restriction in this studying, so theoretic investigation are required. Okay. Few ambitious targets and few reference, but thank you very much.
Okay, let's thank the speaker. Are there any questions?
No.
Okay, there are no questions. Thank you again.
So, sorry, I would like to ask something. I have raised my hand.
Yeah, sure, go ahead.
Okay.
No, you go on, you answer this. That's a question for
you. Yes.
Thank you very much for this interesting talk. I would like to ask something concerning the numerical accuracy that you referred also towards the end. You said that the two solutions were done with some the same or different programs, and there were some deviations on the solution after some time. Is this due to the numerical error of the integration, or is it because the trajectory is chaotic, which means that if you use different codes, for example, or even different compilers, eventually the two orbits will deviate because it is a dynamical feature and not an error in the computation. Thank you.
Yes, thank you for the question. It is very complex and difficult question for you. First, a reason is evident. The different method of integration, symplectic hybrid method and the Everhart method I use in Mercury, and my co-author Eva Pravo in the another program try to integrate this pair. These results are not coincide completely. It's first reason. The second reason is very interesting and more interesting, on my opinion, that real instability of this trajectory. In this context, I can say that as in the yesterday contribution, two criterion of the chaotic orbits was presented, Sally and Galley. It is interesting to apply such a criterion to estimate the degree of chaos of this trajectory after the this transfer, after the few oscillation around resonance.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Okay, let's thank the speaker again.